had a brother that recently got murdered. He got murdered, but he got caught on an elevator with a woman that wasn't his wife. He got caught on the elevator with three women. That shows you the Bible is a true book, because he was committing adultery. And he got killed. Those women he was with set him up. God orchestrated all of that. Read it again.
But whoremongers and adulterers, God will judge.
Whoremongers and adulterers, God will judge. Now, what's some other ways God will judge people that step outside the marriage? What's some other ways? I give y'all one. Say you was dealing with a married man, sis. The wife kicked the door in. What's something that could happen to you? The wife could pull a gun out and blow your head off. That's judgment from God. Same thing can happen to you. If you're dealing with somebody's wife, the brother could come in and just put you to death. God is doing that. That's judgment. Read it again.
But whoremongers and adulterers, God will judge.
God will judge you for that. What's some other ways he'll judge you for fornicating, being a whoremonger, boyfriend, girlfriend? What's some other ways? Deuteronomy 28, verse 58. I'm going to show you another way. Now, if y'all love God, y'all not only going to listen, y'all going to apply the word. Read.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 58. If thou wilt not observe to do all the words of this law that are written in this book, that thou mayest fear this glorious and fearful name, the Lord thy God, then the Lord will make thy plagues wonderful.
So God said, if you don't listen to every word he say, and he mean every word he say, he's going to make your plagues wonderful. Plagues are diseases. So, when you in boyfriend, girlfriend, relationships, another way God will judge you, you will get an STD. Get verse 61.
Verse 61. Also, every sickness and every plague that is not written in the book of Israel.
Syphilis ain't wrote in the Bible. AIDS ain't wrote in the Bible. But
them will the Lord bring upon you until they'll be destroyed.
He'll bring them on you until you die.
That's right.
There is no cure for herpes. There is no cure. There's a new strain of syphilis out here. It's not a cure for it. So we're telling you this out of love. We telling you this because we don't want y'all to go down that road. Prime example, the blue raffle, that's judgment. Do y'all know what that is? That's an STD. You don't even want to look at the pictures of that. Give me Matthew 4:17 again. You got to change. You can't keep doing the same thing. Matter of fact, hold that. Get Deuteronomy 23:17. Do you love that sister you with? Marvin, no, you don't. You know what? You ain't married her. Boyfriend and girlfriend is temporary. This what you doing by only allowing her to be a girlfriend. Read.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 23, verse 17. There shall be no wars of the daughters of Israel.
Read it again.
There shall be no war of the daughters of Israel.
That's right.
Our women, Andrea, you're not supposed to be a whore. You're a princess of God. Ain't no girlfriend. The next man that come in your face, you tell him if he wants you, he got to marry you.
That's right.
You, Marvin, if you love that sister, you're going to make her a wife. A girlfriend is temporary. Well, you, I'm going to tell you something. You ever notice your people... Like when you, look, seriously, all jokes aside, if you ever bring a girl around your family and you say, this my girlfriend, they be like, this ain't his third, fourth one. How long y'all think she gonna be here? That's what your family say. Am I right or am I wrong? They whisper it. So if you really serious, you really care about that sister, you're not gonna treat her like this. Read it again.
There shall be no war of the daughters of Israel.
Because boyfriend and girlfriend, that's whoremongering. That's not treating that sister as she's supposed to be treated. Again, this is love. Leviticus 19:17. Exactly, you do. But that don't mean you sleep with them. Let's go through that. Let's go through that. Drop that. Get to rock 6 and 7. Because you saying something that's heavy. You got to get to know her. Getting to know her don't mean I want to hit it first. I want to try it out. She's not a cop. Get that. Because I know that's what we taught. We had a lot of, I'm going to make it plain. We had a lot of niggas around us. Hey, you know you got to try out first. You got to, bro. See if it's right first before you get serious with her. No, that's whoremongering. God will judge you for that. You treat his daughter like a whore. Imagine that. One day you're going to have children. You're going to have a daughter. And Jay, you're going to have a daughter. Do y'all want somebody to treat y'all daughter like that? Not at all. So the change got to start with us. Read.
This is the book of Ecclesiasticus, chapter 6, verse 7. If thou wouldst get a friend.
So God said if you get a friend, just like somebody, you say you got a best friend, they have to earn that title, right? If somebody want to be your husband or a woman want to be your wife, you must prove them. Meaning you got to try their actions. You got to see if they about what they say. God do the same thing to us. If we say we love him, God going to put us through some things to see if he going to still stick around. That's what you got to do to the people that say they love you. We.
If thou wouldst get a friend, prove him first and be not hasty to quit him.
So a brother buy you the new mics, Andrea. Now he husband material. He get your hair done. Now he husband material. No. A sister make you a plate. Now she wife you material. No. She got to be around you when you going through things. Say you lose your job. Is she going to leave you high and dry? Them are things you got to know. Say you gain some weight after you have a baby to a brother you married to. Is he going to leave you because you gain weight? Them are things you got to find out. I'm going to make it plain. Ride or die. That's what you got to find out. Is they riding or dying for me? That's what God wants. Read it again.
If thou will get a friend, prove him first.
If thou will get a friend, prove him first. Get to know them. I want to get some more. Let's get some laws. Let's get John 14:15. Do y'all love God? Let's get how to love God. Get 1 John 5 and 3 instead. Get 1 John 5 and 3. Let's get how to love God. Can you give God a hug? No, you cannot. Can you send him flowers? No. It's a way that you love God, and the Bible details that.
Bring it out.
Read.
This is the book of 1 John, chapter 5, verse 3. For this is the love of God.
So this is the love of God. Pay attention. How do you love God? We finna see.
That we keep his commandment.
So that's how you love God. Now I'm gonna get a commandment. I'm gonna show you a commandment right now. You breaking God's laws, it's our job to show you so you don't do it no more. Remember, you love God by doing what? How you love God? Y'all both said that. Okay. Read. I want to make sure we're on the page. The same page. Deuteronomy 22:5. So if you love God, whatever God tell you, you with it. You're not going to try to switch it up. You're not going to get an attitude. Whatever God say, I'm going to do it. It's the same thing when you with somebody. When you in a marriage. This the person I love. I'm with him. Read.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 22, verse 5. The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
Andrea, what does that mean? Come on now, sis. Don't play. What that mean? God said the woman shall not wear that which pertains unto a man. Pertain means belong to. The woman not supposed to wear things that belong to a man. What that's talking about? You know what that's talking about. Read it again. Read it again.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
May I ask you again what that's talking about? Look down. Pants. God don't want you in pants. That's man clothing. Think about it. The pants have a zipper on there for what purpose? That's for us for when we go to the bathroom. You ain't pulling out nothing to use it, so you don't have no reason to have that on. Read on.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
Brother Marvel, what that mean? Dresses and skirts. You're not supposed to have that on. Read on.
For all that do so are an abomination unto the Lord thy God.
All that do so, that's filthy in the eyesight of God. You want to do what's pleasing to God because you love him, right? Y'all love God, right?
That's right.
How you feel about that? Get Ecclesiasticus 15 and 13. How you feel about abominations? Because remember, it's all about you loving God. Just like we went over marriage briefly, we didn't go over that for our own health just to talk. We went over that so y'all could know it. And if y'all love God, y'all going to apply that. You're going to start getting more serious with that sister if you love God. Read.
This is the book of Ecclesiasticus, chapter 15, verse 13. The Lord hated all abomination.
So God hates cross-dressing. He hates that. You should have on a what? A dress. A dress. Why? Give 1 Timothy 2, verse 9. What's the purpose of you having a dress on? Because right now, if you're walking down 79th, all of them going to be telling you, hey, check it out, check it out, check it out. You know why. They looking at your backside. You can't be unwise. If you know that's going to give you the bad attention, why dress like that? And I'm telling you this as a brother, because I care. I'm telling you this about you and the sister because I care. We out here because we care. Our bad decisions don't get us nowhere. It's time to change. Read.
This is the book of 1 Timothy, chapter 2, verse 9. In like manner also adorn themselves in modest apparel.
So, Andrea, God wants you to dress in modest clothing. Do you know what the word modest means? Say what? Can't hear you. Appropriate. That is the correct word. Appropriate clothing. That don't mean you gotta dress like Harriet Tubman. You can still be fly. You could have had the matching hat, the matching jacket that you got on with a dress that go with that. It wouldn't have helped you. With fringes on. With fringes on.
Right.
You still would have been fly. But what you got on right now, brothers is just gonna be trying to get up on you to hit it and quit. That's it. And you know that. You know how Nick Rose is. And you, same thing with you, Marvin. If you love that sister, I'm going to ask you, do she wear pants? If you love her, you're not going to let her go outside like that. Because you know the mind of a man. When brothers see women in pants, all they looking at is their backside. Do you let her wear what is them shirts? Help me out, sis, the shirts that got the cut in the front. A what?
Crop top.
Do you let the sister wear the crop tops? That's a problem. Because if she gonna be your potential wife, you can't let her walk outside like that. Because all of that is for you.
That's right.
When you let her walk outside like that, that's showing you don't care.
Look at that.
She's supposed to respect what you say. No, they not. 1 Corinthians 11. No, they not. This is what you got to learn, and this is what you got to teach her. Marva, step up for me. Because you're speaking a little low, and I can't really hear what you're saying. Now, you said, what do I think she going to do when you tell her that? She ain't supposed to give you no look, no attitude, no nothing. She's supposed to respect you. But you got to show her this. Read.
This is the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 11, verse 3. But I will have you know that the head of every man is Christ.
So what we're getting right now is the order. The head of every man is Christ. Head means leader. Christ is your leader. Andrea, can you step to the side right here? I want y'all to stand right here so I can hear what y'all are saying and so y'all can hear this word clear. Christ is your leader. Head means leader. Christ is the leader of the man. Read.
And the head of the woman is the man.
Did you hear that, Andrew? The leader of the woman is the man. Read.
And the head of Christ is God.
Even Christ got a leader. His leader is God. So that's the order. God, Christ, man, woman. So when you get yourself together, Marvin, and start doing what the Bible says, and you start teaching that sister, she's supposed to respect whatever you say. Because what you telling her out of love.
That's right.
You understand? Because
right.
What's something else that can happen to her if she dressed inappropriate when she not with you and she walking the streets? What's something else that can happen? She can get snatched. That's why we telling you today, you can't come out here like that. It's perverts out here. So if you dressing appropriately, like you said, that's the correct word, you ain't got to worry about that. My wife don't wear no pants. My daughter don't wear no pants. One is a safety precaution. Two is God's laws. Three, she dressing appropriately with some self-respect. You got to respect yourself or a man is not going to respect you. You understand that?
That's right.
Read again.
But I will have you know that the head of every man is Christ.
And then only then, once we understand this order, it's going to be structure in the house. The reason why things is out of order, we don't follow this. The woman running the man, the man ain't even there, the children, they all out of whack. Because we don't have no order. We need order and structure in our house. Y'all understand that?
Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us. Subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.